Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a new review. In front of us is the gorgeous, new, beautiful Škoda Octavia Scout. This is the lava blue metallic color. It's back in Octavia as an option. It was removed on the third generation and then reintroduced back again, a gorgeous spec. Now, this is a delivery showroom, so I'll do a little demo of the Scout because the car is sold. So with respect to the new owner, I'm going to be very gentle to the car. I just want to show you, because this is a unique opportunity, the Scout. So I'm going to pull out the key. It's same as on the Octavia, nothing different. So here it is. Now this is the classical Škoda key. You have a physical key inside. You can extend this keychain or a physical key, and then you have the unlock, lock, and unlock the or lock the cargo. Now you get three keys on the Scout. Let's just turn on the lights and unlock the car. You can see mirrors unfold. We have the beautiful, gorgeous matrix LED headlights. Now I'm going to show you a few details. We're going to run around the car a little bit. So what we have here is the different bumper. Now, this difference between the Scout and the regular wagon or estate version of the Octavia is that this car is 15 millimeters higher ground clearance, so it's more practical if you're going on a dirt road, maybe some light off-roading, not serious off-roading in the mountains, obviously, but it gives you just that little bit more safety. Now, you get the car locked itself because I didn't enter. You get the front diffuser in this silver finish. You get the silver mirrors. You get the chrome trim around the windows and the chrome roof racks. You also have this arches and the side skirt in black plastic. I'm gonna come a little bit closer to see this. And you have the 18-inch alloys and 19-inch as an option. Now, coming a little bit closer to see this color, it is just gorgeous, in my personal opinion. Really glad Škoda introduced this back. So daytime running lights turn into turn signals. These are matrix, excellent performance. I would definitely recommend these instead of going for the basic. Now on the Scout, these are standard LED fog lights. So it's just black, no chrome details. Now this, sorry if my sneakers are kind of dials here, so making noise. So this is just painted plastic, but it's metallic finish, as you can see up close. Now you get the chrome around the grille. If I switch to wide lens, you can see the whole car. It's a little tight space, zooming back in. Now this is the radar for the cruise distance and for the emergency braking for the pedestrians. Now, again, since the area is a little bit tight, you can see the car. Now, I'm gonna come here, show you the alloys. So, this car came with a Goodyear tire, and let me see if I can find a spec for you. It is a little bit shiny because it's a delivery date for someone. Now, I'll have to check it on the oh, here it is. So 225 45 R18. So these are the standard 18-inch alloys. You can see diamond cut, gray finish. Quite fancy looking. Now, on the side here, you get the Scout badge. Now, I think I accidentally, when I kneel down, press the key. So with the key, you can open by holding the unlock button, all the windows. They can go all the way down, or you can just pause and then lock them halfway, or lower them, raise them up halfway or all the way. Okay, now over here you have the same, it's like a matte silver finish for the side mirrors. Get the parking card holder. There's an option of heads-up display, but the owner didn't expect that. You have the lane assist camera, light and rain sensor, Should be another sensor in the mirror there for the incoming traffic. So it automatically dips the dim not to blind other drivers, or it creates in the matrix a shade. So this is the bottom skirt. And as you can see, it's plastic, but it's reinforcing the bottom part. Now under the engine bay and the whole rear part is underneath covered with a additional plastic. So it's an off-road package, gives you extra protection. Look at the rear. And then over here, I have to back up into this corner. You can see the whole car. You can see the plastic bumper is different on the rear. It is also painted on the rear. It does imitate like a fake exhaust, but there is actual exhaust on the side here on the left. Now this is the petrol version and it's a mild hybrid. Now this is going to come to this side. So this is the eTec. I'm going to put in the video description below a link to a full technical details of this car. So forgive me, from top of my head, I did not memorize this version. I think this is the 1.5 TSI with 200 horsepower as a four-cylinder inline engine. And it has an option of the 48-volt battery inside plus the lithium-ion battery. It's also aiding you so as a mild hybrid. Now, just to unlock the rear, show those beautiful, gorgeous lights. So they don't want to open up. One reason, because once you unlock the car a few times, it just stops turning on the main lights. One way to fool this is to turn on the electronics and then just switch it off again. Then you can see the gorgeous signature on the rear. And yes, it has the dynamic turn signals. It has the unlocking gimmick and locking gimmick. So there you go. This is just a gorgeous detail that just makes this car look better. And there's another look. So we're gonna hop inside real soon. Just to show you here, you have the ice scraper, and you have, so you can see, the optional alloys. I think this sticker is for the regular car because it's offering you 16 to 18 inch. I mean, it's possible to put it on this car, but the options are 18 and 19. So recommended run is minimum 95. And here you have the, over here, to put your fuel cap when you're refueling so it doesn't damage the clear coat. Once you lock the car, this is locked so no one can steal your fuel. Now on the top you can see another light at the beautiful color, and you can see the aluminium roof racks. You have the shark fin antenna and you have the panel roof on the top. Front part opens towards backwards. Now not to miss the cargo area, which is quite important and probably one of the reasons why you're gonna pick this car. Wide lens, you can see, very practical. Now, this car also, before I forgot, has an extra 10 liters of fuel capacity compared to the regular version. And this has 640 liters, which is massive. So this is like a cave inside. So this is one of the reasons people pick specifically this version of the car, because of the massive cargo space it offers. It even offers more when you knock down the rear bench. Now on the top you have the little button to close. Here we have the roller on the top, so this is how it looks. It has the press here, so this is like some sort of textile material, or more like, feels like plasticky. Has two levels, just press, it opens up. This is for the new customer. So this is in Croatia. You get the triangle, first aid box, and a spare bulb. And then these are the original Škoda floor mats. Octavia These are really good. I recommend these. I have this on my third generation, and I have something very similar on my Tesla Model 3. Now, very accessible. You can get a false bottom here, like a false floor, then would cover those tethered points. And by the way, there's a tethered point here. Those two in the color of the vehicle. You also have some net points on the side here. You have here grocery hooks. So this is the same on both ends, left and right. You can knock down the seats here. This is a blank, and this is same on this side. Here you have the room for the emergency triangle, and then you have the light on the left and right. So both ends, just it's covered on the bottom. You don't see it until you like bend a little bit. This is a cargo area. It can be, you can press here. This could be removed. There is some decent storage inside here. On both ends, this is the cargo net that you get with the car. So it's exactly the same on both ends. Now over here is the load of five fingers. And this is also something I recommend. You have this as a carpet, like a double layered, and then you have the Octavia. So it's a lot easier to clean. And then over here, you get the spare tire. Now, on the front, for the mild hybrid, I believe there should be a battery there, like a smaller battery, but it's pretty cool. I mean, because it doesn't give you any compromise with the cargo space. So I was mentioning no compromise with the cargo space. There's occasional people passing by because there's two offices connected. Close this up, press to close. Nice soft touch closing. Now there's a little echo in the space, but let's hear the closing sound. Okay, a little bit more force. Definitely good closing sound. The doors open wide and the seals are quite good. I always try to notice if there's any additional seals. Now this is the already second generation of the same model. They always do small changes on these. So you can see now I finally managed to fix for the regular audience the autofocus problem on the iPhone 13 Pro. Now the seals do look a bit better, but in my experience, the estate or the wagon version had better soundproof, at least on my personal tests that I did. You can check them on the channel. Hard plastics on the rear, soft materials on the bottom. This is also covered with leather, but hard plastic. You get the chrome in the scalp. Now what's really nice is you get some carpeting inside, so it doesn't really feel cheap that much. This is mostly hard plastic in most of the cars, so if you're new, don't freak out. Let's check out the other details. So as you can see here, the panoramic roof. Very elegant, you can get those lights on the sides. Now these are the cloth seats you get in the Scout. And this really looks like a little retro, to be honest, at least the color combo. And then you have this like Alcantara finish in the seats. So this is very warm and it looks very comfortable inside. You can knock down the seat from the side of the car. You have the seatbelt aligner here, and this folds behind the seats. So also you have those tethered points for the seats. And this, when you push it, it automatically pushes to knock down. That's why you have those openings on the rear. Over here, you can push this up, then you have the ISOFIX. And let's just jump inside. Now I've been in front, adjusted my seat for the front. Enough knee room, plenty of feet room in the lowest position. You have those little lights on the bottom over here. You have AC, no USBs, you can spec those optionally if you want. Transmission tunnel is tall, but not too wide, so not too much narrow either, but it's something in the middle. it's okay. And it's really nice. You get a lot of light inside the car, good overview. You have big windows in the seat pillar, good overview in the rear. I believe this could go maybe all the way and have these touch lights. So for a 2 meter tall person, if you spec the panel roof, it's gonna be, you're gonna be hitting the side, but otherwise the estate version is super spacious, even for a 2 meter tall person. But if you're an average person, or if you have like 190, 180, you should be fine. So your hair might be touching, but it's good. Now, on the side here, you have the hook on the B pillar, adjustable seat belts on the front. You have the little hook is slowly closing. Now, you can adjust the headrest. Now, these seats look more comfier. These are probably from the SUV models now introduced in the Octavia. Have in mind, this is leather, so it's not cloth. And this is the front look. So let's get on the front where you're gonna spend most of your time. In just a little bit. Yeah, so the closing sound is excellent, by the way. And when you open the doors, the lights turn on. Now let's check the front. Oh, wait. So apologies, it looks like there is an option here. There is a little tray with a rubber mat. So I quite didn't see that in the dark, but you can see that option. And you can see now there's a lot more light and the seats are really comfortable. I like the style, to be honest. And there's of course pockets here. I mean, I'm very detailed. There's also a tether point for the front seat if you want to have a child seat on the front. But I've reviewed the Škodas really detailedly. So this is more like if you're following the channel, like an extension of the Octavia as a brand, as a model, excuse me. Side mirrors, you have the signal, turn signal towards the driver. And in some models, there's a light beneath the door. So there you go, Škoda. Now also, if you press here, the car locks, it's a keyless entry, and then you touch from the inside, it unlocks. This piece can be removed. There's a little plastic here, pop, and then it's a physical cylinder. There's also same principle for the rear door handles, only the driver's side has the cylinder for the physical key. Now, front doors open really wide, same as the rear. So this is really easy when you need to put a child seat on the back. And you get also tinted windows on the rear. One way to check if it's a factory tint, if you're buying a used car, you have the Roman 5 there. That's so very good closing sound. You can see the difference between the tinted and non-tinted. These are also like a green tone. See, the car locked itself now because he thought I was not going to enter. Okay, this flashes red when the car is locked. Now this is soft, sounds better. Double sealing. So look at this, one, two, three, like a three seals. Maybe they were working, maybe they were listening to my first reviews and maybe they've done some change. Simply Clever Škoda umbrella on the side there. These are only reflectors on the front. You don't have those as a light. They don't illuminate anymore from third generation. Have a little trash beam here. Again, Škoda Simply Clever features. Chrome. You can open and close from the driver position. A little cloth here. This is all soft. And even this is soft. On the back it wasn't, but this one's padded. It's all a leather. And then you have here folding and heated in reverse, a right mirror with dip, and you have all power windows, and you can individually lock the rear for the kids. Both ends, really like this carpets. Think should be standard. And there's a speaker on the bottom, there's one here. Now, Octavia aluminum doorstep. And these are the manual seats. Up and down, push that one to slide back and forward. This is, I believe, an amplifier, so should be a subwoofer here if it has the audio, but I don't see any labeling on the badges, so I might be wrong. And here you have the tilt and the very important lumbar support. Now, you can see here some details. Now, these really look comfy, and I like the cloth material. Now, I haven't filmed any B-roll, so this video is just like an entry. But this, I think they should have added maybe, okay, not on the top, but it, well, it's a contrast, definitely, if you look at the Scout. And you have the aluminium sport paddles, because it's an off-road package. And over here, you get the standard carpets. Now, you get a little extra room here with the carpet, also feels nice. You can put your keys here, maybe similar stuff. Steering column is manual. You have automatic lights. Just keep it on automatic. When it's green, it's on automatic. You have the ambient lights here. And over here, only on the front, unfortunately, front and rear fog lights. Now this, you get this silver finish. And then you get this cloth matching these seats. Let's hop inside. Sorry for the bump. Okay, so this would be the point of view, really gorgeous. So if you want to see the style version of the Octavia or the plug-in hybrid, I've tested all of them, diesel, petrol, plug-in hybrid. So yeah, let's zoom back in. So you get a two-spoke steering wheel. You can pick a three-spoke. Not sure if it's an option on the Scout though. And look at here. I would expect a Scout here, but it's a blink. You have the sport paddles. You have the nice physical controls. I really love the new Škoda steering wheel. It's one of my favorites. But it's a little big. I got used to Tesla, which has a little bit smaller, like Peugeot steering wheel. So this is a little bit odd, but it's still, it feels good, it looks good. I really like the steering wheel, personally. Tell me in the comments, what do you think? Now you can hear it close or open the air vents. This is soft. Have an air vent over there. You have the speaker in the A-pillar, parking card holder. And this is all soft. Dash, you have the speaker on the top and the air vents in the background. The screen is now on the top, so your eyes are closer to the road. And you have this for the volume, a capacitive slider. This doesn't have illumination because of the infrared sensors beneath it. And no physical knobs, this is just all touchscreen, but you have this physical shortcuts on the bottom. Now I covered this, so it won't be detailed on that end. This is soft, and then on the bottom it hard plastic. This slowly opens. So you have some carpet inside, you have the AC still. That is very practical. Most cars don't have that anymore. And then you have the lights, it's warm. You have a little part here, and should be a, oh, they, I thought it was supposed to be SD card reader, but I think they removed it. And put this back here. And the seats, again, have here the points, you have the Scout here. Very comfortable seats, so let me just, yeah, the Octavia was always a very comfortable car and I liked it. It's not like super fun if you don't go for the sport version, but it is very comfortable and relaxing drive. Now, this is the overview if you're tall on the front. It's a good overview on the back, really big mirrors and a lot of light if you need to turn back. There's also a good overview all overall. Now, before we turn this on, just to wrap it on the bottom, you have the, let me just see if I can share some light on. Maybe no. Actually, we'll do this. Yeah, so you can see that USB-C's illuminate. Really interesting here, they're really rubberized. I think they've changed this. I can't remember from the top of my head. I don't remember if this was rubberized here, honestly. I gotta check my videos, but I think this is new. Wireless charging and decent space. I think there should be some light here. Electronic parking brake. This is shipped by wire. It's just automatic. That's even better. It's improved, and it's really elegant. You push forward and backwards. Of course, you need to press the brake, but it just clears the space. There's no need for big bulkier levers. Excuse me. This is the park button. I was completely on automatic mode talking. This is the electronic brake, and this is the auto hold. Also very important on automatic cars. It's really practical to have auto hold, so you don't need to hold your brake on the traffic light. A little rubbery area here. You can maybe put a key there. You have the roller here, and you have this extender, and this is for your smartphone and maybe for like two coins. This can be extended. And then you have this, and you have adjustable cup holders to rubberize these dots, or if you have a Coca-Cola bottle that doesn't spin around, you can unscrew the bottle cap. This one, so it can go like this because you have to turn it around as it's centered. So it's centered here. So you have to turn it around if you want to put it on the front and you feel like use it like this, but you can close the shutter. I think they should have lowered this, but then it'd be probably harder to take it out. And this is quite nice. It just feels quality, and also has this like a brown stitches, same as on this the seat. Very roomy, also a little rubber mat. You can put stuff here, and there's like a little drop here, so you can put your cables. You can put something if you have a smartphone, if you're charging. You can be inside, so you won't squash it. It has this like little area to extend this. And then it has levels, also very practical. This is reason why we love Škoda. This is like a tall area. There's like a, let's see if I can lower the camera there. It's like a vent. Honestly, I haven't figured out what this is for. I was looking for the additional tray here, but it's not available. Okay. Now, just to show you the lights here, these are setup, driving modes, assists, lock from the inside, hazards. You can even see the dynamic turn signals on the reflection. AC stuff, and then you have those ambient lights. Everything else illuminates white, so just another white lens. You can see that. Okay, let's come and see the digital cockpit. Also, this illuminates. Now, this heated steering wheel is a standard on the Scout. I believe the heated seats were supposed to be option as well. Excuse me, standard as well. But okay, going a little back and forward. This light engine is not broken. Some people could ask, but yeah, it's just a test light before you press the start. Fuel. Temperature on the side. Have the digital cockpit here. You can have pages, you can have the map view, you can have the minimalist view. You can customize the bubbles here, and then you can like go here. I didn't change this is in Croatian, but once you, so you can change this one, and then you can go here into the setup, and you can see consumption, stuff like that, assistance. So there's a lot of stuff. You can see the little icons that you could change here, so you can customize this very extensively. What do you want to see? Sorry, I didn't change this to the you can have the compass, and then you can change by pressing to the next one. I've covered this in one of my videos very detailedly, so you can see that. Okay, so I'm not going to be detailed on this one, but the graphics is quite decent. It's getting a little bit dark, and sometimes after switching to wide lens and then back, the camera just loses like the focus. You can see now how much sharper is this. I think there's a little bug on the iPhone latest software version. Infotainment. I'm gonna be trying to be brief here.
setup. You can turn off, start, stop, SR, and tire pressure. On the top, you have this pull down menu. We here have start, stop, also close air circulation. You can add some shortcuts and brightness. And for the like the buttons and background illumination, excuse me. Then you have here some messages, updates, and so on. The home screen here for the menu, and you have like a fairly responsive screen. Now Škoda was offering some updates, but they still have some issues with this infotainment, and what I hear is they're working on it. So there's no official any ETAs on when is this going to get some proper software updates, but otherwise this car is awesome. This is the Scout, so this is the supports, like a lane and braking. Sorry, again, I didn't switch this to English, but you can see here the avatar, and so this would like a consumption. It's nice they've added the avatar. So these are obviously the 19-inch alloys. Brakes, easy open, windows, central locking, wipers, service position. Is there an option to... No, okay. I thought there was an option to wave your foot behind. Comfort lights. So this is like coming, leaving home, and the ambient lights are on a different position. So just before I forgot, you can see the lights, and then I can show you the long beam. You can see that is very bright. And then you can see, like, if I give a turn signal, yeah, you can see the well, the fog lights aren't turning on. At least you can see them in the reflection. Back on the screen here, you have the smart link. You can use your Android Auto or the Apple CarPlay with the USB. And some setup here, ambient lights, of course. You can do moods here, individual, you can customize these, or you can go here and then play with like a different pattern. You can put like here and like here, and then you can have this. This also changes the appearance of your screen there, and then it changes this obviously. So quite cool. On the bottom you always have these shortcuts, so you have the heated. I thought this was the heated, to be honest. There's a blank obviously then. It'd be cool to have ventilated option, but it's not an option. If you go to the let's see, climate assistant, then you can have the classical, you can have automatic, errands, climate on or off, AC on or off, synchronize. Oh, this one has the front defrost, I think. Air care would circulate the dust from your interior. You have here some AC setup, and then you have the smart AC to defrost, heat your feet, warm your hands, cool your feet, and put some fresh air inside the cabin. Max blow rear defrost, park assist, it gives you a backing camera, and you can choose if you have a trailer. So okay, someone might ask, why didn't you show that? I have a trailer, that's what I wanted to see here. What's the point of this video? So there you go. It's a decent graphics, but so this is just the tones, this is nothing about the trailer. Although the Scout could tow 2,000 kilos. So this is like more wide lens, and this is like, oh, this one's, excuse me, more wider. This is more like a narrow one. The rest, you really saw it in multiple reviews. Navigation. Well, you have a little search. It works like a Google. You can see all of that in my point of driving. This is the map layout. It's quite simple and nice to use. I believe you can also go and here on the automatic, have a night, and there's like, you can see the speed limits and so on. You can set it up. This home menu gives you like half radio, option and the consumption and some shortcuts, you can all customize that. Now you're gonna hear spec the vehicle option, just a second here. So there was an option here let me see here. Yeah, inside, tires, mirrors, oh, inside. So you can, oh, this is really nice. So there's an option of this wood that would look more elegant, especially in the Scout. Tell me what you think. Interior lights, okay. And there's like instrument, I don't want to say echo tips. This is just a restart. I thought there was an option. Yeah, you can actually customize these on those, as I mentioned. Sorry, there's a lot of cars that have different options. Even the Fabia has something on the screen. Octavia has it through the buttons. Also depends on the package and so on. So I can go for like an hour on this car. Trust me, there's 1 hour long reviews. But here you have the setup for the language and so on, if you're that much interested. Now it offers me for the English, but I'm almost wrapped up, so I won't do that because the customer is a Croatian. I kind of realized that I forgot to show you the driving modes. So, which is most important one, you have the Eco, Normal, Sport, and Individual. And I'm a little bit surprised that there isn't the option for off-roading, but there here is Dynamic of Driving, could be Normal or Sport. You have the Steering, Normal or Sport, Transmission, Normal, Sport, or Eco. Assist for lights, whatever that means, and climate. And you can reset all of that. So no off-roading option or anything like that. You can turn it off here. You have face watches, so this is standard, so this is not anything specific to the Scout. And just a little radio demo. Okay, it's not radio media. Let's just find something that's maybe international. Okay, I can't play for too long. You can always pop here and then like customize. There's always you can customize the sound, and you can have the treble, middle, bass, and so on. You can reset it here, you can focus it whatever you want. And then you have like all the, you can have touch tones and so on. And then you have this layout. Once again, this is just looking quite sharp. The camera did go a little bit off, and you can see here if you turn on the heated steering wheel. Gorgeous car, gorgeous details. I wish I could have done a more detailed review, but I'm gonna wrap it up on this one. Let's switch it off. I'm just gonna show you for the end the bonnet. You get this information once you leave the car. And on the top, well, I turned it off, but you can use these. Actually, I forgot to show this part, but you can have here lights on, you can turn them off. If the doors are open, you have the airbag passenger information. You can slide the, well, let's show it to you. This now illuminates white, so you can open the roof. Just press here to stop it. Now I'm gonna close it because it's raining outside. So wouldn't want the owner to. So you can also move that shed all the way, so it gives you nice light inside. And over here you have to press this little guy, and then you have this big red button for the emergency, in case, God forbid, you need something and something bad happens on the road. And over here we have the calls for the SOS. Light on the top, documents holder, privacy mirror. Unfortunately, this area is not covered. This doesn't extend. I hope Škoda will change that in the future. And let's get on the front. So trying to think if I forgot anything. I hope I didn't forget anything. I'm trying to be detailed because this was a little bit unexpected to film the car in a delivery showroom. And let's see if I can back up here. See a little bit better. So dampeners, quite practical. It's not really that expensive. These sound insulation on the top. I believe this was a petrol 1.5 TSI, 4-cylinder inline turbocharged. There's also an option to get a 2.0 TDI, if I'm not mistaken, with a 200 horsepower as well. This is still a funnel for the washer fluid, so you can pour it here or directly here so it doesn't spill around. It's practical, your 12-volt battery and coolant. The rest, leave it to the mechanics. Drops is nice and easily for the opening. You just, underneath the badge, push it to the left. Doesn't need a lot of force, closes perfectly. And that was the review of the Scout. I hope you liked it. If you did, be a cool person, give this video a like, leave your comments below. How do you like the Scout?